Hey dreamers, and welcome to the very last video of this year. I did this kind of video last year already, and it's just really awesome to look back on what we achieved here on the channel, what happened in dreams, what we created, and personal achievements as well. This year I uploaded over 50 videos in high quality, featuring helpful tutorials, detailed breakdowns, inspiring art, incredible community creations, and more. I would say we definitely raised the quality even more compared to last year, and I really want to thank all of you guys for the amazing support and lovely feedback. It has been one of the key factors to keep me motivated and work hard. But now, let's jump back to the very first highlight of the year. The Impy Awards. And first off, MediaMolecule did an incredible job on the show this year. It was truly amazing, and I was nominated for Most Helpful Dreamer and Favorite Video Creator, which made me so happy, and then this happened.
And the winner is Sakku's Mind. Well done.
Yeah, I won the very first and also last Favorite Video Creator Award, because the category does not exist anymore in the next MPs. But yeah, this was such a happy moment for me. I really felt all the hard work and effort I put into the videos being paid off. Later then, I was also in an interview with Kelt, aftershow Discord party and whatnot. It was a wonderful day and a great celebration for the whole Dreams community. I can't wait for the next MPs, and I hope to get a chance to be nominated again. Then, in the beginning of the year, I started to go fully professional as an artist with Dreams and created a fresh show reel of my art, followed by an interview with my friend Mighty Vicious about becoming a professional artist with Dreams. The reel opened a few opportunities for me, and it was great to see your response and support. One of the first opportunities was the music video that I created for the talented artist Tyler Brunel and his amazing song called Waltz. AVNDR then also edited some awesome lyrics and visual effects in After Effects to the video, and the outcome was so amazing. Honestly, more people should watch that music video. MediaMolecule then announced Mega Penguin, an ongoing fun game by MM and the community where you can participate in yourself. We also had a playthrough together here on the channel. In July, it was time again for Dreamscom, one of the big Dreams events where dreamers can present their upcoming projects with trailers and show booths. It's really awesome, and MM did a fantastic job with the show booth this year, and even did interviews with some of the creators and promising upcoming projects. Last year we announced the Crystal Guardian there, and this year we wanted to step it up and created a booth, but especially a very high quality trailer again that I'm still proud of. Your reactions to the game were amazing, and then I also did an interview about the Crystal Guardian with Tom and Jen from MediaMolecule, which was awesome. The whole event was just really cool. Then another really cool thing happened. I created another music video, this time officially for Savella from Fearless Soul, a channel about helping you to improve your mental health, get inspiration, motivation, guided meditations, and all of that stuff, which has helped me a lot in the past. And for this music video, I created a scene inspired by the Bolivia Salt Flat, also known as the world's biggest mirror, a real place. And I think it turned out really cool. I'm really happy that I got to do that for them. I then created a video for WinkFox and their concept art course, which I turned into a Dreams masterclass about how all of you can create detailed scenes and concept art in Dreams, which is one of the best, if not the best video that I've ever made so far. Definitely check it out if you haven't already. There are so many valuable tips and tricks on creating in there. After that, I made the announcement that I joined Cyber Sheep Film to create the world of Noguchi Spell, and my first work was for a trailer that was shown at an official show from the Gamescom. This was so cool, and on top of that, we started our Kickstarter campaign for episode 2, which was the first successful Dreams project to be fully funded on Kickstarter. Since then, we have been working on episode 2, and I got to create some really cool environments with my team. Here are some screenshots for you. In September, my game of the year, Kena Bridge of Spirits, finally released, and I made a couple videos about it, including, again, a super high effort breakdown on one of the most detailed and polished scenes that I have created in Dreams. Still very proud of that one. The scene with my little spirit animation also got MM-picked, which was nice. By the end of October, it was time for Halloween. MediaMolecule did an incredible All Hallows Dreams event with the community, including some fun spaces to explore, mini games to play, especially pinball, and they also did a Halloween jam, which I created some stylized art for, that got MM-picked and reached the second place of the jam. Made me happy to see. You can of course also see how all of this art was created on my channel. In November came the surprising Netflix super hit and my favorite show of the year, Arcane. What an absolute masterpiece. I have watched it 3 times already, and of course with this insane visual style, I had to create something inspired from it in Dreams. And my video about how I created this Undercity Lanes inspired scene was super well received by you guys, and it's one of my favorite videos from this year. Right after that, I was finally able to release my visual story in collaboration with Replica Studios, where I was allowed to write my own story, visualize it with Dreams, and tell it through the voices of Replica. Honestly, this was a dream project to work on, and it's one of my favorite creations that I ever made in my life. I'm really proud of this, and it made me super happy to read your mind-blowing feedback on it. I then also created a very high effort behind the scenes video where I explained you how much thought and effort actually went into this story, including lots of insights, tips and tricks, and just valuable things for life in general. Definitely make sure to check that out if you haven't yet. It was then also featured in the MM newsletter, which was great to see. I also had a few more wonderful opportunities as a professional artist. Some of that is under NDA, so I can't show it to you guys yet, but it wasn't just all as great as it may sound. Of course, I also had to make some bad experiences with my professional work as well. Work that got cancelled, asshole clients, and other things that I don't even want to get into. Also, I'm still living on the edge financially, which I really hope changes next year. Actually, since it seems like MM is taking people outside of the UK now, I think my biggest dream would be to work as an artist or environment artist for MediaMolecule. Apart from that, my goals for 2022 are to improve and grow as an artist in general, but also as a person. I think in terms of that, this has probably been the best year. I've constantly worked on myself mentally and physically. I started creating some healthy habits that I've been sticking to and made bigger steps than ever before as an artist. Now, while I'll let a little compilation of art from this year run in the background, I would like to take some last words. I know this year has still been quite hard for a lot of us, and whatever you're going through right now, stay strong and know that there are better times coming. Use the time you have to work on yourself, just a little day by day. Focus on the positive. Be grateful for the little things. And most of all, we are dreamers, so keep dreaming. Believe in the good to come, and it will. I would also like to thank all of you, my community, You have been so supportive, loving, and cheering. I'm really thankful for your incredible support. Also, a special thanks to my Patreons. It means a lot that you support me as an artist, and I'll give my best to post even more interesting exclusive content in the new year. Many thanks also to MediaMolecule, of course, and for all their effort they put into Dreams and to the community. Even though we haven't seen a major creating update this year, it's all the little things that you do which makes this community and its support the best ever. Now, I'm wishing all of you the best of luck, health, and happiness. On to a great new year, 2022.